Hello friends and welcome back for one more video. In this video we are going to talk about MCQ questions of TYBCom Advanced Accounting, and the topic that I have selected for MCQ is Banking Company Final Accounts. Let me share my PPT. I hope my screen is visible. I'm starting with this video. Once again, I welcome you all to my official academic YouTube channel, that is Academic Insights. If you like my video, don't forget to subscribe my channel. At the same time, don't forget to press the bell icon so that you'll get this kind of videos in days to come. Now, don't forget to like my videos. Also share my videos with your friends, relatives and colleagues, and most important, don't forget to write your comment in chat box. Now I'm starting with your MCQs. These are the MCQs of TYBCom Advanced Accounting Paper 1, and here we have covered topic banking company final accounts, or final accounts of banking company. And here is the first question, and the first question is, the Banking Regulation Act is dash, or Banking Regulation Act is, you know, enforced in which year? The options are 1949, 1947, 1948, 1945, and the correct option is 1949. Moving on to the question number 2, that is, banking companies in India are governed by, who is the authority who governs banking companies in India? That is the question, and the options are, as per Act 1932, Income Tax Act, AS 23, and the last option, that is Banking Regulation Act 1949. And from these four options, we all have to find out a correct option, and the correct option is D, Banking Regulation Act 1949. Moving on to the question number 3, and here we are going to see something about a different sort of concept. An asset becomes non-performing when it to generate income from bank, and the options are is, CGIS, computerized, easy, and the correct option for this question number 3 is CGIS. Question number 4, banks have to recognize their income on dash basis in respect of income on performing assets. Underline this sentence, performing assets. And the options are accrual, cash, credit, and the last one, none. And the correct option for this question number 4 is accrual. Question number 5, banks are to recognize their income on dash basis in respect of income on non-performing assets. See, the words are different, performing assets and non-performing assets. Here they are talking about non-performing assets, and the options are accrual, cash, credit, and none, and the correct option for this question number 5 is cash. 6, substandard assets are certain loan assets of a bank which are classified as dash assets for a period not exceeding 2 years, and the options are non-performing, performing, current, and fluctuating, and the correct options are non-performing assets. We call those assets as non-performing assets. Question number 7, the main function of dash company are accept deposits money, and the options are private, public, banking, capital marketing, and the correct option is public. 8, dash asset is one which has been classified as non-performing assets for a period not exceeding than dash years, and the options are fixed 30, fluctuating 11, intangible 1, substandard 2, and from these 4 options we guys have to find out one correct option, and the correct option is fixed 30. Question number 9. Core banking system is dash system. So the options are bank end, workflow, open end, and internal. And the correct option for this question number 9 is bank end. Question number 10. Every banking company should prepare a balance sheet and profit and loss accounts as on dash each year. The options are 31st March, 31st July, 31st December, and none. And the correct option is 31st March. Every year they have to make balance sheet as well as final profit and loss account. Question number 11. Banking companies in India are governed by Banking Regulation Act 52. So you guys have to tell whether it is right or wrong. And the options are true, false, maybe true, maybe false. And the correct option is it is totally false. Question number 12. The main function of a banking company are to accept deposits of money from the public and to lend or invest these deposits. Whether it is true or false, you guys have to tell. And the correct options or the options are true, false, maybe true, maybe false. And the correct option is true. Next one, that is question number 13. Non-banking assets must be shown in the balance sheet in Schedule 8. Again, you guys have to tell whether it is right or wrong. And the options are true, false, maybe true, maybe false. And the correct options are, the correct option is false, that is B. Question number 14. Every bank has to transfer a dash percent of profit to statutory reserve fund account. Whatever profit they get, that is called as net profit. Out of those net profit or that particular net profit, what percent of net profit is transferred to statutory reserve fund account? And here are the options. 20%, 15%, 10%, 25%. And the correct option is 25%. Question number 15. Bank shows the provision for income tax under the dash. See, there is a, you know, bank always make one provision for income tax. So that provision shows under what accounts or what title they are asking. The options are contingency accounts, contingent liabilities, other liabilities and provision, and the last one, borrowings. So the correct option out of these four options is other liabilities and provision. Question number 16 now. The heading other asset does not include. There is one heading in asset side of the balance sheet, that is other asset, which does not include what out of the given answers. The options are silver, interest accrued, inter-office adjustment, that is debit, and the last one, that is gold. And the correct answer from out of those four options is gold. Question number 17. A scheduled bank shall maintain deposits with RBI equal to at least dash of the time and demand liabilities. So they are asking your answer in terms of percentage. The options are 1%, 1.5%, 2%, 3%. And the correct option is 3%. Question number 18, that is rebate on bills discounted is what? Dash. Options are an item of income, a liability, income outstanding, and the last one, income received in advance. So out of these four options, we guys have to find out one, an appropriate answer. And the option is income received in advance. 19. Dash provision is created for standard assets. The options are 10%, 20%, 30%, and 0.40%. And the correct option is 0.40%. Moving on to the next one, that is question number 20, and this could be the last question. A doubtful asset is one which has remained in the substandard category 4. They are asking in terms of months. And the options are A, 12 months, B, 18 months, C, 24 months, and D, 48 months. So from these four options, we guys have to find out one correct option. And the correct option is 12 months. Here, all the questions are over. I hope you all are understood whatever I told you through this a short video. I request you all again, if you really like my video, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Even don't forget to press the bell icon. At the same time, like my video. And if you like my videos, don't forget to share my videos with your friends, colleagues and relatives. And the last but not least, don't forget to comment in chat box so that I can improve myself in days to come. Thank you very much. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.